Hello learners, you all are welcome to the program on Senior Secondary Mathematics. Do you know how much is height of Mount Everest? Correct. This is 8848 meters. But could you imagine how it was measured or what techniques were used to find out this height? We use trigonometry or say a concept of mathematics for finding out all such heights or distances where it is not measured or it is not possible to measure it physically. In class 10th, we have come across the terms of trigonometric ratios like sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta, cosec theta, etc. But in class 9th, we studied all these trigonometric ratios in a right angle triangle and angles were restricted only from 0 to 90 degree. But if we need to study all these angles which are more than 90 or say which are less than 90, because we know angles are measured in negative or say in clockwise direction also, then what to do? Let us extend our knowledge of trigonometry in regard of all these type of angles, and for that we need to define one unit circle. See, when a ray makes a complete revolution like this, we define it's a circle, and when its radius is 1, we say this is a unit circle. This circle, when on quadrants, it is like this. Then it is divided as 0 degree to 90 degree, 90 degree to 180 degree, 180 degree to 270 degree, 270 degree to 360 degree. Like this, this is also radius and it is also of 1 unit. When this angle is theta and this particular arc length is L, this radius is R, then we define this angle as theta equal to arc length means L upon radius. When this measurement is used, we say this is theta radian. Here we can see when we take this arc length for whole of the circle, then we know the circumference of circle, it becomes 2 pi r, radius is r, and this angle is here 360 degree. Then 360 degree in this way becomes 2 pi radians. Here this is symbol of radian, or we can say further 180 degree is equal to pi radian. So now we have got another unit of measuring the angle as radian. Here now we can find out a conversion formula from which we can convert a radian into degrees, and it becomes 1 radian equal to 180 degree upon 180 upon pi degrees. Or in another way, if we need to convert degrees into pi, we find 1 degree equal to pi upon 180 radians. Now suppose we have to convert 15 degree into radians. We know it that 1 degree was equal to pi upon 180 radians. So now 15 degree will be equal to pi upon 180 into 15 radians equal to pi upon 12 radians. This is the way we can convert a degree measure into a radian measure. Likewise, if we need to convert pi upon 18 radians into degrees, we know 1 radian was equal to 180 upon pi degrees. So, now pi upon 18 radians, it becomes 180 upon pi into pi upon 18 degrees, finally, which becomes 10 degree. In the beginning of program, we said that we will study about the angles which are more than 90. In class 10th, we know the values of all trigonometric ratios were positive when angle was 0 to 90. Let us see, if angle becomes more than 90, then what happens? Here are four quadrants and it is a unit circle. This angle is theta and here this length is x and this length is y. So, and this distance is 1. Here we find that in case of ratios of these three sides, we can name them O, M, P. Distance is OM, MP and OP. When we take ratios of these three sides, in all the cases, because distance is x and y, they both are positive and one is positive. So, all ratios will also be positive. So, we find a conclusion that in first quadrant, all six trigonometric ratios will be positive. Now, let us move to the second quadrant. Now, angle is more than 90, or we say it is 90 to 180. Here, this length now OM, it is x and y. Now, this x is negative and y is positive, this length is 1. Due to the negativity of the length of this x, we find the ratio in which this value OM will be involved, the value of trigonometric ratio will turn into negative. And on the basis of this, we find that in second quadrant, except sin and cosec, all value will become negative. Sin and cosec are positive. Let us move to the third quadrant. Here, now we see the length OM dash is negative and this length M dash P dash is also negative. So, when they both are negative, in third quadrant we find, while finding out the ratios, that tan and cot are positive, but rest of the four trigonometric ratios becomes negative. When we move to the fourth quadrant, here we find this distance is 1, this x is positive and value of y is negative. When we find the ratios of these, then we find that cos and sec are positive and rest of the four trigonometric ratios values are negative. When we need to find out a value which is more than 90 degree, then we see how the values of trigonometric ratios are changed. So now conclusively we can say that in first quadrant all six trigonometric ratios are positive. In second quadrant sine is positive, cosec is positive. In third quadrant tan is positive, cot is positive. And in fourth quadrant cos is positive, sec is positive. Let us extend it further. Again we are drawing a unit circle here. This is angle theta, this length is x, this length is y, this is point P, this is point M. Coordinates of point P, if we find out value of x here, means y upon n. If we find out value of y here, we can say y upon 1 means perpendicular upon hypotenuse equal to sin theta, or it gives us y equal to sin theta. Likewise, x upon 1 means base upon hypotenuse equal to cos theta. So, it gives us the value as x equal to cos theta. In this triangle, if we apply Pythagoras, we get x square plus y square equal to 1. When I replace this value of x theta and cos theta from here, we get sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, which is a very important identity of trigonometry. From the same identity, we can derive these two values, sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos square theta, or say cos square theta equal to 1 minus sin square theta. When we are using this x square plus y square equal to 1, if I divide it by x square, I get 1 plus y upon x square equal to 1 upon x square. In this diagram we can see y upon x means perpendicular upon base. This is equal to tan theta. So, 1 plus tan square theta equal to 1 upon x. 1 upon x means hypotenuse upon base, means sec theta. So, sec square theta. This is another identity. We get it from here that sec square theta equal to 1 plus tan square theta. In another form, we can also write it in this way, that sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Similarly, we can write down the third and final identity, that is cosec square theta equal to 1 plus cot square theta, or say cosec square theta minus cot square theta equal to 1. Using this identity, let us solve one problem. The problem is prove that sine raised to power 6 theta plus cos raised to power 6 theta equal to 1 minus 3 sin square theta cos square theta. Now, we have to think of that which trigonometric identity can be used here to prove this result. Here I can write down sin raised to power 6 theta can be written as sin square theta cube. Likewise, cos raised to power 6 theta can be written as cos square theta cube. Now, if I want to make it a plus b whole cube type, then I need to add 3 sin square theta cos square theta in bracket sin square theta plus cos square theta, and whatever I have added, I have to subtract that also, minus 3 sin square theta cos square theta sin square theta plus cos square theta. Now, these term we can relate it as a cube plus b cube plus 3ab a plus b, means it becomes a plus b whole cube, where a is sin square theta and b is cos square theta. So, we can write sin square theta plus cos square theta whole cube minus 3 sin square theta cos square theta. And we know using an identity that sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. We will replace that value in the next step. Now, in both the places here and here, I put sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So, it becomes 1 minus 3 sin square theta cos square theta. So, sin raised to power 6 theta plus cos theta is proved as 1 minus 3 sin square theta cos theta. Let us move to another problem. These identities are very helpful in simplification. Here it is. Prove that under root 1 minus sin theta upon under root 1 plus sin theta equal to sec theta minus tan theta. Let us see how to prove it. If I multiply this left hand side with under root 1 minus sin theta, then it becomes 1 minus sin theta, 1 minus sin theta upon under root 1 plus sin theta, 1 minus sin theta. Further, this is same, so it becomes whole square, so under root will be removed and numerator becomes 1 minus sin theta. In denominator, we get this is 1 plus sin theta and 1 minus sin theta. When we multiply these two, we get 1 minus sin square theta. It is 1 minus sin theta upon under root cos square theta. So, after removing root, it becomes cos theta. And when we divide it separately, this is 1 upon cos theta minus sin theta upon cos theta. We know 1 upon cos theta is sec theta and sin theta upon cos theta is tan theta. So, in this way, we can use these trigonometric ratios and these trigonometric identities to simplify and in proving of different type of trigonometric results. So, we discussed about trigonometric ratios, how trigonometric ratios change their sign from one quadrant to another quadrant. We defined another measurement of angle, which is called radian. We discussed how to convert a degree into radian and a radian measure into degree. We defined a unit circle. Using unit circle, we defined certain trigonometric identities, and then we understood, we use these trigonometric identities that how to simplify or how to prove different trigonometric expressions. I hope you have enjoyed the program today. We will be ready with the next program next time, the extension of this particular aspect of mathematics, trigonometry, part 2. Till the time, goodbye. Thank you.